while a police officer was stuck in a traffic jam, he notices a suspect car. The police officer secretly chases after it in order to not alarm the suspect. Suspect goes past the police officer and the police officer goes back after him. The police officer then decides to pull the suspect over. The suspect fails to stop for the police officer pulled in front of him to slow him down. The suspect then goes round the police officer and puts his foot down.
I want this guy, okay? So move it.
I don't see where that is. The helicopter is with you. The helicopter came before she took place, just in case. The police officer is now doing 110 miles an hour, and his speed is increasing 130. The suspect is slowed down again. The suspect went on the wrong side of the road. And not the pole from the guy, which is now in the middle of the highway. The police officer temporarily loses control of the cop car, and but is now right behind the suspect and is leading the pursuit. The police officer rams the suspect, but the suspect drives away and cuts in front of a big HGV. But the suspect can't go anywhere because his alpha male is no match. The police car. A car that the suspect hit then goes into the police officer. But the police officer only had a minor hit and is now back on his way again. But then all of a sudden, it turns to the right and then he loses control of the police car and hits the civilian vehicle. And his dash cam goes all wobbling.
Hector isn't here right now, but I'll happily slap you for suggesting
the police car that was behind the suspect at one point that crashed is now out of the chase.
No, it is important to let me drive so you can rest.
But the police car is after him. And then loses them. Meanwhile, another police car, is going through an emergency where someone has stolen an Alfa Romeo Giulietta. He is heading to the scene at 160 miles an hour, but then spots the suspect going the other way, so he does a U-turn on the highway and then go back the other way. It seems the suspect has seen the officer and has put his foot down. Police officer out of the corner of his eye sees the Alfa Romeo go off the highway and then they didn't shoot again. Police officer takes a shortcut to try and cut off the suspect, but the suspect knows where the police officer is and then drives away. The police officer has to go through a checkpoint door to block off the suspect. An apparent retail gets in the suspect's way. The police officer loses sight of the suspect, but then later on, like the first police chase we saw, arrested the suspect. But the police officer has now spotted a speeding Cadillac, which he is in pursuit of. And as you can see from the rear camera, there are other police cars chasing. Even going around the corner then. The suspect manages to lose the police officer because the police officer spins down. As you can see, Chevrolet Corvettes are now on to shoot at the Cadillac, and the police officer that we are following now only has a Dodge Charger, but is still keeping up with the Cadillac and is now overtaking the Camaros and doing 150 miles an hour. But then the suspect police officer skids on the corner, nearly hits the civilian vehicle and nearly hits a lamp pole. And then the suspect was caught again. Dash cam captures the moment a civilian vehicle goes out of control, but then the civilian catches the moment a lorry spins out of control and stops to help. But the lorry drives away. But then doesn't stop in time and hits the car, as his car doesn't have anti-lock brakes. He then gets pulled along by the lorry. The civilian vehicle with the dash cam pulls in front of the truck stopping and then brings the truck to a halt. A civilian vehicle captures the moment a lorry skids round the corner and takes up two lanes.
You probably shouldn't pay too much attention to that.
And then cuts up the civilian. So then the civilian stays back and there is about three other cars behind him that are all stuck and getting past because of the slow vehicle moving all about, and then the lorry won't let the camera in. And then a kind person behind the camera lets him in, and then, as you saw before, the lorry swerved into onto the motorway and then speeds up and then slows down. The camera then overtakes the lorry and then pulls in behind the taxi, which is going slow as well. So then he pulls onto the outside lane because there's another lorry on that lane. Then stops to help in a very serious incident. He then backs up because of the severity of the accident, and everyone is plowing into it, not stopping in time. The camera then pulls the rest of the foot, government into it, and then pulls over and saw the three other cars behind him. The moment when his vehicle goes straight into a skidded van that has skidded in an accident, and another van gets hit by other cars. The dash camera pulls to the side of the road, and then other helpful car members of the public see if he's alright before the accident. Moment, a Lincoln Town Car dash cam catches a moment in Audi driver, goes a bit mad, doing 26 miles an hour on the highway, and then speeds up. The Lincoln driver then goes past him and pips his horn for being such a stupid person, and then the Audi driver continuously tailgates him, and then goes alongside him, then starts shouting at him and pips at him. The Lincoln driver then floors it. And luckily for him, the Audi driver goes too fast around the corner, hits the barrier and ends up skidding and then getting sideswiped by a civilian vehicle. And then the Lincoln driver calms down as well.